and welcome to Big Deal. Today we are aiming for an interesting conversation between bulge bracket private equity firm Warburg Pincus and its investee portfolio company Stellar Value Chain Solutions. So I have with me both the gentlemen. Warburg Pincus India head Vishal Mahadevia joins us in the studio, and we also have with us Anshuman Singh, who started the company Stellar Value Chain Solutions. Gentlemen, so good to have you on Big Deal. Now, it's interesting to talk to both the parties, Vishal. But first, since we have you in the studio, I'll take the advantage of that and ask you about the investment climate in the country. We are in election season. Economically, also in terms of macros, a lot of things are changing. Oil is one of the factors. Apart from that, the global growth concerns have also been spoken about from various central banks as well. So, putting all that into perspective, how is India positioned in terms of an investment destination for Warburg Pincus?
The macro environment here, I would say, is mixed. But the opportunities for India, and the reason I think it's interesting, is your point about global growth. Global growth is challenged.
Right.
And India has that opportunity to have a multi-decade growth run.
Right.
And really, when you look at it a couple of decades down the road, be one of those economies that can be the next 10 trillion economy globally. It's possible.
Right.
Is it preordained? Not at all. Is it a lot of things that have to happen between now and then? Yes. Policy, government, all the things. But I remain, and we remain at Warburg Pincus, optimistic that India will get there, and we'd like to be part of it. To answer your question on investment climate very quickly, I think it's an interesting time for private equity.
Yes.
And I think we've been here for 25 years, and finally it feels like private equity over the last few years is an accepted asset class by entrepreneurs, management teams, folks like Anshuman, to really help grow their businesses.
Since you spoke about Anshuman, let's talk about his company first. And would you like to talk about why does this particular space, especially logistics, transportation, warehousing, supply chain, really interest Warburg Pincus in India? Not just Stellar, you have a few investments made in this particular sector in the country.
Yeah, sure. I mean, it's three real reasons. And to be crisp about it, the first is it's a very large market. I mean, the last numbers I saw is the logistics spend in India is north of $150 billion, if not even more when you count different ancillary parts of logistics. Anshuman's company, Stellar Value Chain, is effectively driving and addressing a large part of that market. And that market is broken in many ways.
Yes.
The logistics supply chain in India, it's too expensive. It's fragmented. It's been subscale for years because of tax reasons, regulatory reasons, other pieces.
Yes.
And I think there are a number of factors where a disruptor like Anshuman can come in and create a better mousetrap, give the consumer a better value proposition, and therefore grow his business and create a really valuable company. And the last part of why we did it is Anshuman. I mean, we are, as in Warburg Pincus, we are investors. We back talented entrepreneurs. And we're lucky we found Anshuman. I mean, he built the logistics business at the Future Group. He's been in this business for decades. His domain expertise is deep. He's an outstanding individual and someone we felt we could partner with. And honestly, training under Kishore Ji, who's another entrepreneur who we have a lot of respect for, it just gave us a lot of comfort. So we're thrilled to be with him.
All right. So you've spoken a lot about Anshuman. So Anshuman, you have made three acquisitions in a very short period of time, the latest being Patel Roadways recently. What are you aiming at with these acquisitions? And is that going to be the way for beefing up your company?
The businesses that we are in Stellar Value Chain, out of the 160 billion market going up to 250 billion in the next 2 years, the businesses that Stellar is in, all those are high entry barrier business.
Right.
They're, for example, contract logistics requires infrastructure, scale, automation, and more than everything, it requires a deep knowledge of it, which we have. On the express side, you have to build a network pan-India, and that takes years.
Yes.
That's what brought in the acquisition strategy. We said to save time, and since GST has already arrived, e-way bills are already settled, this is the time to scale up fast on the entire value chain.
Right.
And that's why we did three acquisitions.
Yes.
For the perishable goods, we did Kelvin Cold Chain.
Yes.
For the express transportation, we did the acquisition of Innovative Logistics last year. And now we did Patel Roadways, which is a 60-year-old company, which has 350 branches built over 60 years penetrating the whole country. It reaches out to 15,000 pin codes across the country.
Yes.
Fits very well with our end-to-end value chain transformation ability for our customers.
So this is looking like a classic case of also platform building, Vishal. Now, this is one such scenario where Warburg Pincus has really not acted like a private equity firm. You've pretty much given seed capital to Anshuman to really start off his business. What is this particular strategy, and through this platform, what is Warburg looking to achieve?
So I think there were two thoughts to it. You're absolutely right, Nisha. Usually when we think of a platform, we think of an acquisition to start the platform. But I'll go back to it, and I feel I'm praising Anshuman too much. But honestly, he's an outstanding individual. So when we met him, we wanted to get this started. And I think for Anshuman, and I won't put words in his mouth, but it also was important to have a firm that had deep pockets.
Yes.
Because while we started out with seed capital, we always knew, given the fragmented nature of the market and given the opportunity, that acquisitions may come up.
Yes.
We have no guarantees in life. And it's worked out that way. We were able to do the seed capital for the contract logistics business.
Right.
And then find the acquisitions to continue to power the other businesses. And I think, as Anshuman said, that is going to continue.
Right. So it is a very different kind of, investment that has been made by Warburg. You are pretty much fueling the growth through the acquisitions. What is the appetite going forward? Is this particular strategy going to continue? And which are the other areas that you are eyeing for acquisitions?
So the strategy is build or buy or do both. And we are doing both. For example, in the contract logistics piece, there are not many players available. But now we are actually evaluating the classical CNFs, the carrying and forwarding agents. Obviously, there are some very large players in the country which did the classical traditional warehousing system for a lot of FMCG companies. We are eyeing them. We are looking at them. Either some of them will evolve to 3PL players or they will sell out, because that's the movement from the unorganized to the organized. A lot of technology, a lot of capex, and a lot of infrastructure will be required for these CNF players. Either they will sell out or they will evolve. Now, the people who are looking to sell out are the ones we are looking at.
Right.
On the transportation side, again, the value-added players who have network across the country and come at the right price or something, because we are also builders. We know how to build businesses.
Right.
So unless there is a right price, we will not buy. But if something, if a good equation comes in, a good price comes in, and a good network and value-add comes in, we'll definitely look to buy.
All right. And Vishal has already stated that things are expensive, assets are expensive in this area. But Vishal, you have a majority stake in Stellar. What is the kind of role, apart from also fueling their acquisition strategy and giving them funds for it, what is the role that Warburg Pincus really plays in decision-making here?
I would say that our philosophy, Anisha, is very much the same whether we are a majority or a minority investor. Anshuman is the entrepreneur. The management team is a terrific management team. So we help in either of those situations. We would help in team building. Let's make sure we have the right people. Let's get the organizational structure in place, because we have great hopes, as does Anshuman, on the growth potential of this business.
Right.
But it doesn't grow on its own. You need outstanding people. You need outstanding systems and technology.
Yes.
So we provide help like we would to any company, whether majority or minority, to Anshuman when he needs it. So on the technology side, we have a person in-house who works with all of our investee companies, helping them assess their technology needs. He can be called upon when it's required. We help, obviously, on the funding, we help on the organization, and we help on strategy and capital allocation decisions. The business itself is run by Anshuman and his team. Day-to-day decisions, the way the business is run, is really him, and we're backing him.
But also, Vishal, to the larger point, and this is exactly at a time when everybody is talking about the relationship between a promoter as well as an investor. We have had cases between VG Siddharth as well as Mindtree. We have seen in GMR as well as GVK, there have been many issues between the investors as well as the promoters. So it's clearly coming out as an issue that promoters have with the private equity investors on board, and there is some clash of ideas. What has been your experience so far in India, and do you think this is specific to India or across the world there is a clash between, while there are not many promoter-driven companies, but between management as well as a big investor?
So let me answer the questions one by one. Firstly, from our perspective, we're proud to say at Warburg Pincus, we have never had any such fight in our 25 years with a promoter or an entrepreneur. We're partners. Partners will debate, we'll disagree with each other multiple times, but we never lose sight of the fact that we are investors. We're going to be there, we're there to help build the company to a stage, but at some point we will exit. So if we've backed the right person, we're going to respect them, we're going to debate, and hopefully our partners in most cases want to hear us out. They respect our opinion and we go with it. So I can say I'm touch wood, wherever it is, we've never had that happen. I can't comment on the cases you talked about. I can say this is global. There are fights that are going to happen, but the cases that you pick up whenever there's a disagreement tend to be noisy.
Yeah.
And so they get a lot of the headlines. But in the scheme of the amount of private equity investment that has been made into India, there are a substantial minority of the cases.
So I take your point on
that's
that.
That's what I would say.
Yes, I totally take your point on that. But understanding a promoter's mindset also, Anshuman, but you've been a professional in a promoter-driven company, and now you are a promoter of a company. What is it in your mind, the mindset difference between a promoter and an investor?
In fact, when I founded this company 2.5 years ago, some other funds also had got in touch with me and I did my due diligence. And one of the factors...
This time the due diligence was on the other side.
Yeah.
one
of the reasons why we went with Warburg and why we decided to partner with Warburg was that they had this reputation of backing the entrepreneur and giving the entrepreneur a complete free hand to build businesses. Today, after 2.5 years, I can say that if I had to turn back the clock and go back 2.5 years and I had a choice again, I would still do the same deal with Warburg Pincus and nobody else. And that happens because in the last 2.5 years, believe me, it was my decision to dilute my equity and get a majority player in Warburg. But today, I have never ever felt in the last 2.5 years as to who's majority, who's minority, whether I am the promoter or not. And the way Warburg works, I can't comment on other funds, but the way Warburg works, they align the interests completely. And if the interests of both the parties are completely aligned, there's no way that there can be any dispute. In fact, till date, then forget a dispute. We have not even had a disagreement.
So what is brought to the table besides the funds that is really priceless for Stellar for its growth?
Other than funds, they bring a lot of comfort and confidence that we are backing you, we believe in what you're doing, and that's a tremendous amount of backup. I mean, that's an emotional comfort. That's a financial comfort, and you can do things fearlessly.
Right.
That, okay, we are backing you, don't worry. Our interests are aligned. Our interests are completely aligned. So there's never been a debate in terms of alignment of interests, in terms of how we take the companies forward, in terms of belief in the country, in belief. So this is a complex business. This is a business which only now is gearing up for the next phase. This is the business of transformation of the country. All other sectors have leapfrogged. Now, this sector is still not leapfrogged, and this will now jump, like telecom, this will jump generations. This will jump the intermediate pieces of the rest of the world has gone through. So this will move from completely unorganized traditional methods to completely modern over the next 5-7 years.
Right.
Now, that requires a lot of belief in the country, a lot of belief in the economy, and a lot of belief in the people. And it has to have a mutual alignment of interest between the fund and the promoter, which is there in this case.